I'm going to talk about acne today. Let's dive in. Acne is the bane of teenagers' life. Not just teenagers, though, it affects up to 80% of people, ranging from teens to age 30 and sometimes beyond. What is acne? Acne is a common skin condition where the pores of your skin become blocked by hair, sebum. Sebum is an oily substance, bacteria, and dead skin cells. Acne causes pimples, mostly on the face, forehead, chest, shoulders, and upper back. There are a variety of causes including genetics, fluctuating hormone levels, stress, high humidity, and using oily or greasy personal care products. If you have acne, no, you're not alone. It's the most common skin condition that people experience. It's estimated that 80% of people ages 11 to 30 will have at least a mild form of acne. And most people are affected by it at some point in their lives. What are different types of acne? Blemishes, bumps, pimples, breakouts. There are plenty of words we can use to talk about acne. Because there are so many types of acne and several treatment options, knowing the differences can be tough. The best way to treat acne depends on how severe it is. Acne can be mild or a few occasional pimples, moderate or inflammatory papules, or severe nodules and cysts. Let's learn about the six different types of acne, how they form, how they look like, and what you can do to treat them. The first two types of acne we'll discuss, whiteheads and blackheads, are both non-inflammatory. This type of acne is usually easier to treat than inflammatory acne, so over-the-counter or OTC treatments may work. The last four types, papules, pustules, nodules, and cysts are types of inflammatory acne that can be harder to treat. Number 1. Whiteheads. In almost all cases, acne happens because the pores in your skin are clogged. Clogged pores can happen when there is too much oil, bacteria, or skin cell production, or as a result of hormonal changes. Whiteheads, also known as clogged comedones, happen when pores are clogged all the way through. The length of the pore and the head of the pore are closed, creating a little white bump on the top of the skin. It's important to note that whiteheads can't be removed or fixed by squeezing them, so do not try to pop them on your own. Otherwise, you may end up with scarring. OTC whitehead treatments include sulfur, salicylic acid, or benzoyl peroxide. These topical treatments can be applied to the whitehead itself or as an entire facial treatment. They help remove the skin cells and excess oil, with benzoyl peroxide being the most effective option and sulfur being the mildest on your skin. Salicylic acid may help prevent non-inflammatory acne from returning in the future. Topical retinoids, which are derived from vitamin A, are also effective for treating non-inflammatory acne. Examples include retinol, adapalene or differin, and tretinoin or retin A. Retinoids help clear acne by unclogging pores that are full of oil and dead skin cells. The American Academy of Dermatology considers retinoids to be the core of topical therapy for acne. Number 2. Blackheads. Unlike whiteheads, blackheads look black on the skin's surface. They are known as open comedones because the head of the pore remains open, while the rest of the pore is clogged. Blackheads can be removed by squeezing, although that's not recommended because it can cause scarring. Treatment options for blackheads are the same as treatments for whiteheads. Try to avoid using pore strips to pull out blackheads. Pore strips are an abrasive temporary fix that can damage the top layer of your skin, making acne worse. Number 3. Papules. Papules are small red bumps that form when oil or excess skin cells block a pore and mix with bacteria on your skin called Cutibacterium acnes or C. acnes. The contents of this blocked pore spill out, which allows the bacteria to escape into the surrounding skin tissue. The bacteria then create an inflamed lesion. Papules do not contain pus. The OTC treatment benzoyl peroxide may still be effective for treating papules and other forms of inflammatory acne because of its antibacterial activity. Additionally, your dermatologist may prescribe a topical retinoid, antibiotics, or birth control pills to help combat inflammatory acne. Antibiotics may help get rid of C. acnes bacteria, and birth control pills can help reduce oil production by decreasing androgen levels. Androgens are male sex hormones, but they are found in both men and women. They can increase the production of oil on your skin. Number 4. Pustules. Pustules are small, bulging bumps with a white center and red, inflamed skin surrounding them. They are usually found in clusters on the chest, face, or back. Pustules form when a blocked pore gets infected, but they can also be caused by hormonal changes in the body. They are similar to papules, except pustules contain yellowish fluid known as pus. Popping pustules may cause the bacteria to spread, so do not try to pop or squeeze them. Only your doctor can safely drain pustules. The same OTC and prescription treatment options used for papules apply to pustules. Antibiotics are almost always recommended in order to get rid of the bacteria-filled pus. Number 5. Nodules. Nodular acne consists of flesh-colored or red bumps that are deep under the skin surface. Nodular acne is usually a result of the C. acnes bacteria causing a painful infection deep within the pore. Since OTC treatments work on the surface level of your skin, they aren't as effective for nodular acne. A dermatologist can help you get rid of acne nodules with prescription-strength benzoyl peroxide or salicylic acid, antibiotics, retinoids, or birth control pills for women. If medications don't work, your doctor may drain the nodules by hand or use a laser or chemical peel, a process that removes the outer layer of your skin. Number 6. Cysts. Cystic acne is the most severe form of acne and is also the result of an infection deep within the skin. Acne cysts are large, red, inflamed, painful, and pus-filled. Cysts are softer than nodules because they are pus-filled and often burst, infecting the surrounding skin. Cystic acne is the most difficult acne to treat. Your dermatologist can help you fight cysts with medications like isotretinoin, which is an oral retinoid also sold under the brands of Clarivase, Miorison, Xenotane, and others. Antibiotics, topical retinoids, birth control pills for women, or spironolactone or aldactone. Spironolactone, like birth control, can help reduce androgen levels. However, it is only used to treat acne in women because it can cause unwanted side effects in men. You may require multiple medications in order to get rid of cystic acne. Your provider may recommend injecting stubborn cysts with steroids in order to treat them directly and get rid of the inflammation. Now there is a very important question. Do certain foods cause acne? For the most part, hormonal changes in the body drive acne. There is some evidence that skim milk, whey protein, and diets high in sugar may cause acne breakouts, although this remains controversial. Chocolate has not been directly linked to acne. Eating a balanced, nutritious diet with plenty of fresh fruits and vegetables, especially those rich in vitamin C and beta-carotene, helps reduce inflammation. There is also some evidence that eating fish can help. What should I do while waiting to see a dermatologist? Continue washing your face at least daily with lukewarm water and a mild facial cleanser that you can buy over the counter. Products containing benzoyl peroxide and salicylic acid are effective as well. Can acne be prevented? Preventing acne is difficult, if not impossible, during normal hormonal changes, but some things can help. First, wash your face daily with warm water and a mild facial cleanser. Second, routinely use moisturizer. Third, you don't have to stop using makeup, but try to use non-comedogenic products and remove makeup at the end of each day. Fourth, keep your hands away from your face. Do you struggle with acne? Share us your experience in the comments section. So, this clip or this video has come to an end. Did you enjoy this video? If so, hit like, share, and subscribe to ASAP Health and click the notification bell. Make sure to watch these videos. These videos can help you in your life. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.